Hello everybody, this is quite the video for me to make. If you can get past the introduction and you want to watch the new version of this game, look in the timestamps. I have timestamped this video. For my subscribers and long-term viewers, if you're not a subscriber yet, as you'll know, this is one of my most popular videos. And in fact, this year in 2022, my tipping point unboxing video became a most watched video at over 300,000 views. Thank you all so much. I'm really chuffed about that. And what's quite fitting is that this year as well, Tipping Point have released a new board game for it. Yeah, there's a newer version of this. To recap, if you've not watched my original one, it's Tipping Point, the TV show, the quiz show, the game show. They made a game out of it. And it's just like a coin pusher. And in fact, in this very machine, I have put 5p's into it. It does push 5p's and 1p's if you want to use proper coins instead of these tokens. When I reviewed it, and I've used it in many YouTube videos now, it is not without flaws though. And the main problem is that the shelf keeps juttering once it gets any kind of weight on it. And that's not just with the 1s and 5p's, but even with tokens, it has a tendency to get stuck and it starts not being fun anymore. There's also a casting mark in the plastic. See that? Which makes it a bit, the quality not that good, really. The game is not quite following the quiz show on TV. For instance, there's these freeze tokens and there's a lose two. This is not something that's in the TV quiz show. There is times two counters. And there is also something else as well. Lose two there again. There's another counter. Oh yeah, there's also these different coloured counters as well. And there you go. The game before as well. There is meant to be Tipping Point stickers, but I never bothered to stick them on. Here's the questions. You get two types of cards. There's the blue questions, and then there's the red questions, which are multiple choice. A bit like the quiz show in the sense that it just goes to multiple choice at the end. That is that. What else did I get? Oh, there's some more of the tokens. I keep them in this ramekin because the game doesn't come with any kind of box or anything to keep all the pieces together. So this is something that I put them in. See, all these stickers you're meant to stick on the plastic. And that's a quick rundown of the original review. I can't believe it's got so many views. And there's the instruction leaflet. You don't really get an instruction book with anything anymore, do you? Although, really, I think they could have saved money on this by just printing this on the inside of the box and letting the box unfold out or something. But, hey-ho, that is that. Right, let's get to the main point of this video, which is the new version. I went into a Robert Dyas today. And if you don't know what Robert Dyas is, it's like a posh version of Wilkinson's. If you don't know what a posh version of Wilkinson's is, it's Robert Dyas. It's a bit... Do you know what? I'm starting to like Robert Dyas more because Wilkinson's has lost its way a bit. It's not as hardware as it used to be. You used to go to Wilkinson's to get... better turn that off because it's making a racket. Works on 2 AA batteries. Yeah, Wilkinson's isn't as good as it used to be. It's lost its way a little bit. I'm quite annoyed about that. Let's get the new game out. Right, let's compare the boxes, shall we? There's the new box. There is the old box. This is Ben Shepherd, who was on the box. He is the presenter of Tipping Point. I think Tipping Point's been gone for now something like 12 years. I do like Tipping Point very much. You may have gathered that. Right. The ages of playing the game has remained the same. It says recommended ages is 10 and above. Shall I get that into camera? It's just slightly out. That's not changed. What has changed is Ben, though. They've clearly used a new picture of him. Maybe it's his new PR picture. He actually looks a bit better on the newer version. He looks a bit washed out. It looks as if they shot a light bulb in his face and took a picture. And he wasn't quite ready for the picture. His handkerchief is more whiter rather than... looks like that's just the intend, inside out, outside in of the inner lining. And yes, he's quite always got one extra button undone on his shirt than normal. But he's actually got it done up more on these. Yes, he's usually got that one undone as well. quite often shows his chestage a bit more on the TV. Chestage. And pretty much the boxes are pretty much the same on the front, really. And where they have remained identical, pretty much, is on the back, where they've got this, where they've kept the bloke with the weirdest expression I've ever seen. They've kept this annoying picture on the back. I did say this in the first video 3 years ago. Why are they playing it backwards? They can't see what they're doing. If I pull it closer, you'll be able to see what I mean. See what I mean, look. The board is facing us. We don't know whose hand is this. Is it your hand? Is it my hand? Whose is it? It's a massive hand, though. It's about the size of his head. And they've got the questions upturned so everyone can see the answers as well. It's very strange. I don't know what his expression is. I don't know why she's so happy to be putting a token in. Clearly, what she can't see what is happening. Well, look at that same picture. Fun for all the family, it says. Both got over 650 questions. Pretty much everything has stayed the same. They've removed the question mark. Choose a drop zone. I don't know why that is a question mark. I've only just noticed that. I think that's a mistake. On the box here, on the old one, I'm thinking that this is a date stamp because it says 10/17. That's got to be October 2017. Oh, it can't be 2017, can it? What an idiot I am. Well, anyway, here is this one. It could be a date, couldn't it? Yeah. Yeah, I think that is a date, actually. October 2017. This one's got a new one. And it says April 2021 is when this one was made. And I think the only difference in the box is the makers of the TV show have now got their name stamped on it. I think that's maybe another reason. Still made by Ideal. It's the same box. Right, let's get into the new one then. This is what we want to see. Right, I actually got the person in Robert Dyas to get this out the stock room because the two that were on the shelf, one of them, annoyingly, somebody had opened up. I don't know why people need to feel they need to do that in shops. And the other one was just a bit bashed. But it looks as if people are buying the game because the shelf was quite empty of this game. Right, same as before. A lot of cardboard. But this is new. Look at that. And I'm hoping they've changed the mechanism so it works better. You can actually see through it, look. Oh, I wonder if it smells that nice plastic. Hang on a sec, let me sniff it. Oh, it does. It smells of new plastic smell. That smells nice. And then here's the board. Oh, is this board bigger? It's bigger. Ooh. This is more interesting. This is more interesting straight away. Ooh. Oh, it's seal packed for freshness as well. I ain't got any scissors. I have to rave into it. There we go. Oh, this is much more impressive. Oh, I didn't know they changed the size of the thing. Let's stick that on there like it's meant to. Hopefully, I'm really hoping they've fixed the problem with it. There we go. And now let me get everything else out of the box and I'll show you the size difference. Well, even straight away, look, I'm having to put it further away and it's still not in camera shot. There's my questions, just sealed for freshness, but not in a box or anything. Erected in 1889, which famous tower in Paris weighs almost 10,000 tonnes and is 324 metres tall? The Eiffel Tower. It's the same tipping point questions I've had. Very easy questions. They're exactly the same tokens again. There's been no change to the tokens. I am far more impressed with that. The instruction book looks as if it's been updated. No, it doesn't actually. I thought that's just because it's newer. Mine's been shoved in that box, so it's got more creases in. This looks as if it's exactly the same one. In fact, they've even recycled the instruction book because that is clearly the old machine on there, isn't it? There is no way. See what I mean on that bit there? That is the old machine, isn't it? Yes, so the instruction book is exactly the same. That's silly. And that is everything. Where's the stickers? Is that it? Oh, yes, you just get one sticker this time by the looks of it. I'll just double check, but I think it is. Just the one tipping point sticker to put at the top, which I will not be using. Let's open this instruction book. Is there any more stickers in it? No, there is not. Let's get this cardboard out the way. Oh, I'm actually really excited about the bigger board, actually. That is far more interesting. There's the old one. Next to it, look. It's bigger. And you put the coins in there. Just a bit bigger, not much. But still a sizable difference. The only thing that they've not changed, which is a bit annoying, is when the tokens fall off the edge. Oh, no, they have changed it. Oh, they have improved it. Oh, that's good. Not much of a ledge, but there is now a ledge at the front, which means now that when your tokens, they don't just fall out everywhere. I'll give you a demonstration, look. That's before. Does it work? This is now. There you are. They're going to fall out there, but that's one of the quirks of the actual game show on telly. Sometimes the tokens leap out the machine. The counters, rather, not tokens. It looks as if they've used the same backing panel. Is that the same? No, there's slight differences. Yes. Let's get some batteries in this. We'll be able to tell from the sound of the motor if they've actually improved it. Oh, someone need to take that off for now. Does this still lift off? Yes, it does. This is all nice and see-through now. Look. Oh, look, everything's red. Woo. It's a bit... Is it grubby? No? Right, it's still the same battery shenanigans, two double A's. Let's get the batteries in. It's one of those safety mechanism things, look, where they've always... You know, these days, everything's got to be like this. You see, I think this actually makes it worse. Let me know if you agree, because at least before... Oh, God, I'm dropping my screwdriver. Before, right, when it was just a press thing to get the batteries out, yeah, sometimes it was quite difficult. You needed to use a 2p or a 50p or something. Whereas these days, if you lose the screw, which is quite feasible... Or is this one of the ones where the screw is permanently in? All right, ignore that. But sometimes it isn't, is it? And people are just going to use some tape. You know, if they lose this or if they break this, they're just going to use tape to go over it, which exposes the batteries anyway. I think the old way is actually still better. Let's get some batteries in. There we go. Is it turned off? Because I don't want to... Yes. I don't want to surprise myself. Oh, I hope it doesn't play any... Might mute... Actually, yeah, I think when you first turn it on, it should play the theme tune of the game show, which is... And maybe it should sing... maybe it should have a recording of Ben Shepherd saying, "Hello, welcome to Tipping Point." Something like that. That would be mega cheesy, wouldn't it? Right, here we go. Oops, fingerprint magnets, quite clearly. Let's plonk the thing on. There we go. And put the thing on. Oops, too close. Oh, I hope it works. Oh, it's got lights! Ooh. I'm hoping this works as good as what I'm hoping it will do. The addition of the lights is nice. I think that's pretty much the same speed. Have they just used the same motor? Let's put the old one on just for continuity. That's pretty much the same, isn't it? Oh, it's like an amusement arcade now. Let's put some tokens in. I'm not going to bother to open these ones. They have put them in a resealable lock, though. I think that's new. I'm pretty sure that the old version did not come with a... press close bag. It might have done, I don't know. Let's get some counters in, shall we? There we go. I think it's easier to get the counters in. It's still not separated out into its drop zones though, which is a bit annoying, because on the actual game show, obviously it's drop zone 1, 2, 3, or 4. Well, this, it doesn't matter, because if you put it in drop zone 1, 2, 3 or 4, it still ends up going into the same bit anyway. And drop loads of these in. Oh no! It still does it! Oh! This is exactly what this one does. It gets stuck. And the same, and what it is, it's the same problem. These are too wide. When it goes in here, the shelf rubs up against it. And then it gets stuck. It's not doing it now, but as soon as a token or a counter goes under it, you watch. Oh, I was really hoping that they'd fix that problem, because it's such an obvious fix that they could sort out. And it ruins the game when it gets stuck. Dropping my counters everywhere now. Oh, I know I'm hitting the camera. Let's get that back centralised. Yeah, I'm disappointed that the shelf still gets stuck. I do like the new bigger coin drop bit though. That's good. Now, I know that I'm making loads of riders here. And there's lots of scenes that you can have with tipping point that they've all, I think they've all been invented by Ben Shepherd, like a boomerang or a ghost drop and this, that and the other. They do make its way into the instruction book. A ghost drop is where the air is trapped between the token and at the counter and the drop zone. So it drops really slowly. There's a boomerang drop, which I think is the one where it just like shoots all over the place and ends up coming out. I can't remember the other ones actually, off the top of my head. But no, tipping point is great. I love watching it on TV. I like taking part on it on Twitter. It is quite, how can I put it? It's all just a little bit of a laugh, you know. You know, if someone, just like you would at home, if someone gave a stupid answer to a question, just a hair. If someone gave a stupid answer to a question at home, you'd say to whoever's in the room with you, wouldn't you? Stupid idiots, wouldn't you? Or, what are you on about? The third letter of the alphabet is D. You would, wouldn't you? Well, we'll just do the same thing on Twitter, and it's hilarious. Oh, that would be a ghost drop. Oh, that was quite good. I didn't think it had happened. I'm putting counters in because I want to see if the shelf at the end catches the pieces. Oh, that one's got stuck! Now, that never happens on the game show. I wonder what would happen if that happened. I wonder if they just stopped filming. That never happens. That's the first time it's ever happened to me as well. Oh, that's hilarious. There is actually more counters than this, but I don't know where I've put them. I thought I'd kept them somewhere safe. So that's why I'm going to cheat just this once. Because I'm just reviewing the game. Yes, unfortunately, it does have that same stuck jittery thing that the old version does. I do like the new lights and I like the new sparkly look. I think the more crystal-like plastic is more exciting. It would have been nice if there was a light in the drawer. Just to finish it off, you know, I think that would have made it look really good. But the questions, you know, still come in this plastic thing. The bag that these come in is nice, but it's not big enough to hold the cards in. It would have been nice if this was actually etched on with tipping point rather than having to stick on a tacky sticker. I do like the... Oh, you can actually put two next to each other. I don't think you could do that in the old one. Come on, I want a counter to go over the edge to see if the shelf works. I'm not going to do that if I keep riding my counters, am I? Oh, here we go. Oh, look, I won the star. Yay, I've won £10,000. That was quite lucky. Yes, very, very good. But it's still not perfect. To finish this off, I suppose I should put some 5p's in it and some other coins to see if they work still, shouldn't I? Bear with me. Right, let's see. if 5p's and 1p's still fit in. 5p's are about a little smaller than the counters, but they are just a little bit thicker. Ooh, let's put a few more of the 5p's in. Ooh. Oh, that's just hanging off the edge. One more, then I'll put a penny in. Ooh, it fell off. Right, pennies are a little bit bigger, but not much. And of course, they're still a little bit thicker. Ooh, is it going to work? I think it works better with pennies. Ooh, bowled over to drop zone one after I put it in drop zone four. We'll put one more penny in. Ooh, went back on itself. I forgot the sound tipping bomb that happened. So yeah, if you're going to play this with coins, use the pennies. And lastly but not leastly, I'm going to see if it works if I drop in my Interrobang counter, which is of course a character that I think should definitely come back and I think should be on Twitter. And as you can see, it's a question mark with an exclamation mark. Something like what you'd put on the end. She did what? Like that, so it's a question and exclamation mark. And really? You'd have as a question mark and an exclamation mark instead of having it as two separate characters. In the 1960s, you could have it as one character. Then for some reason, it fell out of use. And it gets stuck. No, so don't modify your own counters, because they may get stuck. But yeah, there we go. Yes. Do I like this one more than this one? Do you know what? If it hadn't been for that silly jittering thing that it does, I would have said absolutely. But it's pretty much only slightly better. I like it because of the lights. I think the material is much nicer. I don't think this one's got a casting mark. Yeah, yes, it has actually. It's still got a casting mark. So they're using the same machinery to make it. That's probably why it's still got the same problem. But it does have a shelf at the end. It's got a little, what's that little dot there? Just scratched it off. I thought that was just a little plastic dot. Anyway. Yes, that's my review of this. Thank you for watching. Thank you everyone so much. It's really great that I got such a popular video. This one getting over 300,000 views is just amazing to me. Thank you all again. Scribes, which means share, comment, rate, subscribe, and share, comment, rate, and subscribe. Yes. And it's Scribes, isn't it now? It's been Scribes for about 2 years. So it's Scribes, share, comment, rate, and bell subscribe. There we are. Thanks for watching. Bye.